Welcome to Maths Genius. Today we will be covering an important topic in the English language portion. Welcome to the lecture series, and today we will be discussing a very important topic, and that is how to attempt a 12 mark question in the AS Psychology paper, that is the new revised syllabus 9900, 12, 11 or 13. Okay, so as we are aware that it is the last question, and we have to write the strengths, weaknesses and their description, and that description should be linked to a specific study. And then we will be looking at issues and debates. The first one is the easiest one, that is nature versus nurture debate, as we are aware of it. The second is individual versus situational circumstances, right? And this will be helpful in the case studies as well, and in the long parts as well. Then we have like free will and determinism, right? We will be using it in the and we will be using this part mainly in terms of like whether the volunteers were like giving ethical guidelines or not, or whether their consent was taken or not. Then free consent in ethical guidelines, and then deception. If you remember the study of like misinformed group and other parts. Okay, so these four are the main points in the major issues and debates, that is the nature versus nurture, individual and situational, and ethical guidelines. Well, ethical guidelines are important and they are part of every study, right? And similarly, like nature, some studies are nature based, some are another like nurture based. In the ethical guidelines, if you look at the paperwork study, so we can write about something about Alex caging and etc. Then food, then they are given the same number of amount of anesthetics as they can bear, because they are animals, they are not given extra or anything else. So in terms of anesthetics, in terms of pain, etc. Now we'll be looking at other parts as well. For example, if it is related to animals, then whether a proper license has been taken or not, right? And then the dosage amount should be equal to the animal's what we can say receptivity, not more than that, and the deprivation in terms of food and etc. shouldn't be there. And they should be allowed to live in their natural habitat. Now we will be looking at a sample question, that how we can attempt this. This is taken, the question is taken from the paper 11 of October, November 18. And that this is like evaluate Dement and Kleitman in terms of two strengths and weaknesses. And the evaluation must, one of the evaluations must be about the quantitative data. So the first things first, if you remember, like Dement and Kleitman study was in the biological studies, right? So the first thing is that it was a lab experiment. So if it is a lab experiment, then what are the key features that you will be writing it down? That it is a highly controlled experiment and highly standardized. So if you recall, the participants were asked to come at their normal sleeping time and not to intake any alcohol or caffeine, because it has an effect on sleep patterns, right? Because if you recall that alcohol sometimes like causes dizziness, etc. So just we have written the word effect, right? So it influences. We haven't told that it whether it will adversely affect or it will have a positive effect, right? So effect is okay. Then we are talking about the EEG and the EMG scans, and why they were used. They were used to monitor their brain activity and eye muscle movements, and it was done to find out when they entered the REM sleep and what was the corresponding eye movement at that time. Similarly, the types of eye movements recorded in the REM sleep it was quantitative, right? So we are now, because it was specifically asking that we should write about the quantitative data, so that's why we have mentioned. Along with it, the number of instances data participants recalled were also quantitative in the REM and the NREM sleep. And the types of recall, the four types of recalls that were there, it was also quantitative, like the horizontal, vertical, little or no eye movement, and mixed eye movement. Similarly, that data could be used to make further statistical inferences. Similarly, the brain waves and the activity that was taken by the EEG monitor and the EMG was also quantitative and reliable and could easily be replicated. However, since the participants were in the lab, they would have felt highly uncomfortable, which could have adversely affected their sleep patterns. Now, this is where I have used the word, right, adversely, because it could have a negative impact. Then this would have reduced ecological validity of the study, because, right, you are not in your natural environment, so how can you sleep? Some people can't even sleep, some people barely sleep, so we are looking at that pattern. It also lacked mundane realism, another weakness, I have written the word weakness to point it out. Then another could be that some people have a tendency of having caffeine or alcohol before going to sleep. So it would have a negative impact as well on the sleep patterns. This reduces the reliability of the experiment. It also introduces individual characteristics because it could have been different for everyone. Some people have a tendency, some don't. So how they would have catered that? So this is another weakness, and this would have influenced the final results. Now, looking at all the points, if it's a 10 mark question, at least 10 points should be explained, right? The first point, lab experiment. Second, controlled and standardized. Third is like take alcohol or caffeine. Sleep, 3 points are there. Fourth, number of recalls, eye movements recorded. That was a quantitative data, number of instances was 5. Then explanation is also linked with the study. Remember, fellas, that just don't write that, okay, it isn't linked. It should be linked with the study. Then we have like statistical inference, what we can do further. Another clearly mentioned, replicated, uncomfortable. Then the explanation why it would have been uncomfortable, 9 points. 10, the reliability of the experiment and individual characteristics. This is an example of a perfect answer. The examiner would say that it covered all the points. Each point was explained as well and linked. The candidate didn't miss the specific details. The specific details of each study are really important. That's why the question is designed in this way, that it should cater to all the things. I hope that you will have a good idea now how to attempt the AS paper. Best of luck for your exams, and if there are any queries, please feel free to ask in the comments. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and share this video. And subscribe my channel for more videos and updates.